It had the longest claws nature has ever produced, and in pop culture, it's known for slashing down a giganotosaurus on the big screen. But the reality of the Therizinosaurus is stranger, and in many ways more fascinating than fiction. Towering over 5 meters tall, that's over 16 feet, and weighing over 5 tons, this herbivorous giant stood taller than a giraffe, heavier than a hippo, and it may have been intimidating enough to make the most fierce predators think twice. Nicknamed the scythe lizard, Therizinosaurus earned its title from the enormous claws discovered alongside its fossils. These remains were found in Asia, primarily in Mongolia, and date back to the late Cretaceous period, around 70 million years ago. The first fossils were discovered in the 1940s, but at the time, scientists weren't sure what kind of creature they belonged to. The claws alone were enormous. The largest claw measured over 1 meter, 3.2 feet in length, earning it the title of the longest claws of all time. Even early paleontologists thought they must belong to a turtle-like animal or even a massive sauropodomorph. Eventually, these assumptions gave way to a clearer understanding. In 1988, the discovery of Alchosaurus in China, one of the earliest known members of the Therizinosaur group, helped reveal the Therizinosaurus wasn't a turtle or a long-necked herbivore, but something entirely different. Today, we classify Therizinosaurus as a theropod dinosaur, part of the Maniraptora clade. This is a group that includes raptors, bird-like dinosaurs, and even modern birds. Therizinosaurus was truly a bizarre animal by dinosaur standards. It measured up to 33 feet in length, 16 feet tall, and weighed over 5 tons. Its long, narrow neck supported a small head with a beak-like mouth, while its body ended in a short, stubby tail, unusual for a theropod of this size. But of course, its most iconic feature was its claws. Each hand had 3 long curved claws, with the largest measuring more than 1 meter, making them the longest claws of any known animal, living or extinct. That includes extinct megafauna like the giant ground sloth and even modern species with famously long claws, such as the giant anteater or armadillo. Nothing else comes close. These claws were so extraordinary that they even earned a place in the Guinness World Records. But the claws weren't the only remarkable part of the Therizinosaurus's limbs. The arms themselves were long and muscular, with a combined reach of up to 2.5 meters or around 8 feet long. The points of muscle attachment, especially for the biceps, were exceptionally well developed, suggesting that these arms were not just long, but extremely strong and capable of withstanding high stress. To understand how this unusual creature came to be, we have to look back at its ancestors. One of the earliest members of its lineage was the Falcarius, a dinosaur from North America that lived during the early Cretaceous period. It was small, weighing around 100 kilograms, and likely used its long claws for gathering vegetation or defense. Over millions of years, this lineage grew both in size and specialization. Members of this group became taller, more upright in posture, and developed the long necks, beaked mouths, and distinctive claws that define the Therizinosaur group today. This gradual transformation culminated in Therizinosaurus coleniformis, the largest and most iconic member of the clade, and the species we recognize today as Therizinosaurus. With claws this large and intimidating, it's easy to imagine Therizinosaurus as a predator, slashing through rival dinosaurs in battles for survival, and indeed, popular films on the big screen have portrayed it in this way, but the truth is quite different. Despite its fearsome appearance, Therizinosaurus was herbivorous. Its claws weren't used for hunting, but rather may have served a range of functions, including foraging, gathering vegetation, or defense. Some paleontologists have proposed that it may have used its claws to help pull down branches and strip leaves from trees, making it a high browser, similar in behavior to the modern giraffe. However, recent biomechanical studies suggest that these claws were relatively delicate and not well suited for forceful actions like digging, piercing, or heavy pulling. Although it is important to say that these theories are still debated and should be viewed as ongoing scientific hypotheses. But something that does seem increasingly likely is that the claws played a role in visual display or intimidation. Many researchers now think the Therizinosaurus was a highly territorial and potentially aggressive animal, similar to large herbivores today like hippos or elephants. Though it didn't eat meat, it would have likely been dangerous when provoked by defending its territory. At this point, it's easy to imagine that a 5 meter tall animal, waving 2.5 meter long armed, tipped with massive spear-like claws, created an unforgettable and possibly terrifying display to ward off predators or rivals. and if cornered, Therizinosaurus could deliver a powerful sweeping blow. While the claws may have been too fragile for prolonged combat, a single strike could cause some serious damage. For decades, the claws of the Therizinosaurus have dominated the conversation, and understandably so. After all, they are the longest claws of any known animal, living or extinct. But as new studies have shown, there is more to this creature's story than its fearsome hands. Recent research has revealed fresh insights not only into how these claws may have functioned, but how Therizinosaurus may have behaved, interacted with others, and even communicated, all adding unexpected depth to this already bizarre dinosaur. So let's dive deeper into the famous claws of the Therizinosaurus. While earlier interpretations imagine them being used to slash, stab, or even decapitate opponents, a 2023 study published in Nature Communications presented a much more nuanced view. Using digital models and stress analysis, the researchers found that the claws of the Therizinosaurus, despite their terrifying appearance, were biomechanically unsuited for forceful impacts. Their internal structure suggests they would have been vulnerable to snapping under high pressure, making them poorly adapted for stabbing in combat situations. Instead, the study proposed alternative uses. The claws may have served a gentle raking or grasping function, perhaps pulling down high branches or manipulating plant material. In short, more of a tool than a weapon. This interpretation aligns with an earlier 2014 paper in Proceedings of the Royal Society B, which analysed the skull anatomy of the Therizinosaurus and its close relatives. It found that the animal had relatively small jaw muscles, a beak-like mouth, and a lightweight skull, all of which point to a selective herbivorous diet. These adaptations likely allowed it to nip or clip soft vegetation rather than crush or tear. Combine that with long arms and giant claws, and a new picture emerges of a surprisingly delicate giant adept at precision browsing in a crowded ecosystem. But the story doesn't stop at feeding. In the same 2023 Nature study, it also raises the possibility that Therizinosaurus's claws played a behavioral or social role. The researchers point out such exaggerated anatomical features like enormous horns, frills, or crests are often used in modern animals for display, not combat. It's possible that these claws, visible from a distance and unlike anything else in the animal kingdom, may have helped individuals signal dominance, warn off rivals, and even attract mates. While we may never know the exact behavioral repertoire of the Therizinosaurus, the idea that it uses its claws as a form of visual communication fits with patterns seen in both extinct and living animals. In this light, Therizinosaurus begins to resemble animals we're more familiar with today. Not predators, but highly specialized, sometimes territorial herbivores. Consider modern ostriches or cassowaries. Large, feathered, and visually striking, they use their body language and displays to communicate, and though generally non-violent, they can be dangerous when provoked. Therizinosaurus may have filled a similar ecological and behavioral niche, but on a much larger scale. Even its posture and limb proportions suggest a possible role in social signaling. Standing upright with long arms and massive claws held forward, Therizinosaurus would have made a dramatic and unmistakable silhouette in the late Cretaceous landscape. Whether it was flailing its arms in a territorial warning, performing a slow swaying display during courtship, the claws may have been as much for being seen as they were for reaching plants. Of course, not all of these ideas are confirmed. They are hypotheses based on biomechanical modelling, comparative anatomy, and observed patterns in modern animal behaviour. But they are grounded in peer-reviewed research, and they reflect a broader shift on how paleontologists interpret dinosaur anatomy, not just as machinery, but as part of complex living ecosystems where communication, social behavior, and display are as important as muscle and bone. Ultimately, these new insights make the Therizinosaurus even more fascinating. Rather than a brute force killer, it may have been a highly specialized, surprisingly graceful browser, one that used its size, reach, and appearance to survive and interact in ways we're only just beginning to understand. The reality, as always, is stranger and far more interesting than the movies. Though we now know much more about the Therizinosaurus, there's still more to discover, including the circumstances of its extinction. What we do know is that the Therizinosaurus thrived during the late Cretaceous period. It was highly specialized for its environment, with a towering reach and a foraging style that gave it uncontested access to vegetation high above the ground. It had few competitors, and even fewer predators brave enough to challenge it. But like many of its contemporaries, Therizinosaurus met its end around 66 million years ago. Its extinction was not due to competition or predators. Instead, it was part of a global event, a mass extinction triggered by an asteroid impact estimated to weigh over 1 quadrillion metric tons. The aftermath of this impact led to catastrophic environmental changes, including wildfires, acid rain, blocked sunlight, and collapsing food chains. Even giants like Therizinosaurus, perfectly adapted to their ecosystem, couldn't survive the sudden and dramatic shifts that followed. Therizinosaurus was a creature that challenged expectations. It was a theropod, but not a predator. It had enormous claws, but not to prey on other animals. It stood taller than almost any other land animal of its time, yet fed on leaves and ferns. Its evolutionary path, from small therizinosaurs like the Falcarius to the towering Therizinosaurus coleniformis, is a remarkable example of how diverse and adaptable the dinosaur lineage truly was. And while films may continue to exaggerate its ferocity, the true story of the Therizinosaurus is far more fascinating. It was one of the most unusual and misunderstood giants of the dinosaur world, an animal that combined power, intelligence, and specialization in ways that continue to surprise scientists even today. My name's Joe, and I really hope you enjoyed this video on the Therizinosaurus. On screen right now are two videos that we think you would absolutely love to watch, and remember, subscribe to the channel to stay updated on the next dinosaur we learn together.